David Welk for a minute. David has been an inspiration. It takes an individual sticking their necks out, doing a lot of hard work, getting up early, working late, thinking creatively outside the box to make something incredible like this happen. And a lot of that, not all of it, but a lot of it was David's hard work. So thank you so much. Really appreciate it. I know a number of people were here 365 days ago. As David referenced, it's his grandfather's birthday. It's my mother's birthday. I say that because this not only has professional importance to me this day, but personal importance. And I also say it because as I look around the room, a few of you have my mother's cell phone number. Make sure to text her and wish her a happy birthday. You got that, BB? You got that, Drew? You're on it? Good. Thank you. I'm also thankful 365 days later, we did not have heat when we broke ground. And it's great to be in a beautiful building with heat. As David mentioned, it was about 5 years ago that we were called into a meeting. Vanessa Phillips, the Chief Administrative Officer of Newcastle County, and myself were called into a meeting with the leaders of a group I had never heard of called the Friends of Hockessin Colored School number 107. I grew up in Wilmington. I went to public schools through elementary school, Shipley School, and then I was bused into Harlan Elementary School. A court decision came down when I was in second or third grade that was a follow-on case to Brown v. Board that caused me to change my school patterns and be bused into the city of Wilmington, into Harlan. Growing up here, I, of course, learned about Brown v. Board of Education, 1954, the historic decision, what a law school professor told me was the most important decision in the history of American jurisprudence. I knew growing up in Delaware just about nothing about the history of this state, of this school, and not only this school, but as was referenced, schools in Claymont, in Buttonwood, and across this state, segregated schools that are the very heart, that are at the very heart of that Brown v. Board of Education decision. So I got up from a meeting where we have a lot of meetings where people come and they want all sorts of money and resources from us. I know the governor, Lieutenant Governor, Representative Carrie Evelyn Harris, Mike Smith, Paul Baumbach, and Councilwoman Kilpatrick. We know about those meetings. People come in, they ask for something. Fortunately, I go into many of those meetings with Vanessa Phillips, who's here somewhere. She is not only an extraordinary chief administrative officer who effectively runs county government every day, she is the first African-American ever to serve in that position. She also, fortunately, is someone who, when I say a lot of nice things in meetings, will walk out and say, Matt, you know we don't have the money or any way to do that. And that's what I'm used to. And so after this meeting, I turn to Vanessa and I'm ready to hear all the reasons we can't do this. And she says, we are doing this. She says, we are doing this. And in hindsight, in the years that have followed in our conversations about this project, which for us, I know like the governor and lieutenant governor and so many people here, is not just another professional project, but it's a project of passion. I know for Vanessa and I, it's about our own history, our own experience going to schools, understanding she in Washington, D.C., and me here in Delaware, knowing that we are a product of a system that could be so much worse, that is so much better because of the work of Chancellor Sykes, because of the leadership of Sunny Na and the classmates here who insisted that this story continue to be told. For the work of others, I see Savannah Shepherd's mom here. It's been mentioned, this is the 250th park in the Newcastle County Park System. The 250th park. At another one of our parks, the Green Bank Park, a high school student came to us, came to Senator Brown and a few state legislators and myself a few years ago. And said, you know, there was a lynching. There was a lynching, a racial lynching in Delaware, in this park, a little over 100 years ago. And so she brought that history out in the open. We put a monument there because of her work. We put a monument there. And I know Savannah's mom remembers that monument was stolen a few months later. It was taken away. And we put it back. And it, there today, we drive by. Every few days, I drive by. Make sure it's still there. But it's an important reminder. It's an important reminder that as we stand in a place of beauty, of joy, of education, a place where there are injustices that happen right here. And there are still places where those injustices continue. And the genius of this place, the genius of David, of Josh Martin, who came talk to us, and so many friends of Hockessin Color School put together this plan, is that we're going to use this very same place, this very same place, a monument of our history to create a better future. Thank you so much.